Hi, Tom Joyner. How are you?
Hey, everybody. First lady on the phone.
Good morning.
It's the first lady calling. How are you guys doing?
Hey, Miss First Lady. How are you?
I am good. How's everything going there?
Everything's
in the
going
world?
Real good.
I can't
good.
Tell you. You're just everywhere. So
yeah,
how's going everything good. Going everywhere?
Everything is going good everywhere.
Good.
And thank you for the invitation to the Black History reception. That's going to be Wednesday, but that's kind of short notice, Miss First Lady.
Yeah, well, you know, we have the inauguration going on.
Yeah, I had other things before. You all were creating Black History.
Well, it was one of these things where you don't know if you're going to win.
Mm.
And then you sort of everything else that you normally do, you start thinking, okay, well, maybe they won't want to do this. So, you know, so we're going to get back on it and, you know, make sure that we, you know, have really outstanding programs. But, you know, we've got 4 more years to do some really good stuff. So, you know, in addition to creating Black History, we are going to celebrate it and creating more of it every single day.
Let me talk to you about your girls and Black History Month, because we had an interesting conversation the other day yesterday on the show. Roland had a lady on from Montgomery, Alabama, who was upset that her 5-year-old was taught Black History and slavery by having him be a slave on the auction block. And so the question was, how old should your child be to talk to them about slavery?
You know, I mean, first of all, everybody, you know, has different traditions and beliefs about when you talk to your kids about anything. We come from a household of lots of talking. As early as possible, whenever they're starting to ask questions and things come up. So we kind of follow what life has to offer, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, so when things, you know, so, you know, I would say we started talking to our kids very early about life in general and our history. And, you know, for us, we can talk about these things in the context of our own family, especially mm-hmm. You know, now that there are books written about my ancestry and, you know, Barack has written about his. I mean, that conversation is, you know, a regular part of our lives. And we live with my mom, you know, who is their direct connection to history. So when they get curious and they want to know about what life was like for, you know, my mother's father and what she remembers, I mean, we encourage those conversations to happen as much as possible. But not every family, you know, feels the same way, and it's hard to kind of dictate what people do in their homes. You know, but I think our kids need to understand this history, and they need to understand the consequences as it impacts their lives every day. I just don't want my kids to be shocked or stunned when they are confronted with, you know, racism or things that, you know, come up because of somebody else's history. I want them to be prepared. You know, and the best way to prepare our children, I believe, is to talk to them honestly and openly as often as we can, whenever we can.
Do you think, Mrs. Obama, because you all have made such history and just on the other end of another historical thing with the African-Americans winning re-election to the White House, do you think about your legacy and your place in history?
You know, it's more and more now that we're in the second term, but I have to say that... you know, it's hard to get that time to reflect yet.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I just honestly, because the days just fly by,
right.
You know, so I am trying to be more proactive about thinking about that legacy and thinking about how do I document that? How do I share it? What's the best way? You know, how am I making sure I'm creating something that's worthy of talking about in 50 years or 100 years? So, you know, right now I know Barack and I are just still in the throes of making sure we're getting stuff done that has an impact on the lives of our kids and our grandkids. And that's, you know, I mean, you watch the news, that's an everyday battle.
Yes, it is.
And it's an all-consuming battle. We relish it and, you know, we're trying to make the most of it to make sure that, you know, the folks who raised us and whose shoulders we stand on, you know, feel like we are worthy of this responsibility that we've been handed over, and you know, we want to make the most of it.
Do you think your young babies think about what their legacy might be one day?
My kids?
Yeah.
Oh, heck no.
it's not that deep.
No, I'm sorry.
They're just trying to get through algebra and
the first yes. Lord, it's like, how do I get to TV?
But you are making history in terms of and your legacy, because now you're celebrating the anniversary of your physical fitness program.
Yeah, we are kicking off the third anniversary tour next week, Sybil. Thank you for asking about that. But we are 3 years into our Let's Move initiative, and you know, while we still have a lot of work to do, we have more gains to make. We're starting to see some improvement in the trend lines over these past a few years, which you know gives us reason to hope that these small incremental changes that we're encouraging people to have, the shift in the culture in terms of what we eat and how much we move, is slowly but surely beginning to have an impact. So we're going to spend 2 days on the road. We're going to be in Chicago, my hometown, and we're going to be in Mississippi. We're going to be in Missouri, and we're going to be celebrating some of the successes that have happened. We're going to be highlighting some new initiatives around physical fitness. And, you know, we're constantly trying to figure out how to keep this momentum going, because it is a generational goal. You know, it's too soon to measure whether we've, you know, accomplished it, because this is something where the kids born today, you know, we need to be looking at them when they're on their way to college, wondering, has there been an improvement in how they think about their health and how they manage their health? So we still got a lot of work to do.
Yeah. What do you think your biggest accomplishment is as far as the program?
You know,
is concerned?
There are many, but the improvement in the school nutrition standards is key. You know, that was we haven't seen improvements in school nutrition and the lunches and breakfasts served in public schools in several decades. You know, so the fact that kids in schools all across the country are getting more vegetables and whole grains and fruits in their lunches, they're learning to you know, like wheat pasta over, you know, regular pasta. You know, we're really starting to push physical fitness, finding ways to get that back into the schools, because I don't know if you know, but fewer than 10% of the schools in this country have PE or recess. And that's, you know, I mean, that is a far cry from where things were when we were all growing up.
Absolutely,
and everybody
yeah.
had recess, everybody had gym.
Yes, that's the only class I got an A in. No, not gym. Not gym. I'm a fat kid. Recess.
Recess.
Recess. Well, a lot happens in recess. Then you move, and I had my first kiss.
And so did Tom. Yes, yes. That's where he makes his best moves, outside.
Recess is a highly important part of the day. But, you know, fewer than 10% of our schools have it. And we know that, you know, sometimes that is the hook that keeps kids motivated academically. So, you know, we're going to be doing some of that over the course of this week. And
what was his name?
The first kiss.
Theodore Ford.
All right, then. Teddy Ford, wherever you are.
Teddy. Young Teddy.
She called my name. She called my name. Did you hear that? Did you hear that? She called my name.
Yeah, Teddy, we've heard the stories before. We know about Michelle Robinson.
I told you. See, y'all thought I was lying. See?
Give Teddy a shout out.
All right. Happy Black History Month.
Keep up the great work, Mrs.
Absolutely.
Obama.
Absolutely. It's always great to talk to you. And we're going to be doing some partnering, too, coming up. So I'm
All
looking
right.
forward to it.
Excellent.
Tell the big chief I said hello.
Okay. Absolutely.
Bye-bye.